talking real guns, I'm talking real outlaws.
They saddle up and ride on in town. It was high noon in the morning, saloons you knew what was going down. They took it outside, took it outside. It was man to man, stroke to toe, you know they.
Hello everyone, my name is Ikale and this is Tier 1 Gaming. Now in today's video, I'm playing Medal of Honor Warfighter, a game that I really haven't played or even thought about in years. Now when this game launched, it got such terrible reviews that EA actually decided to stop supporting the game just a few weeks after it launched, and they dismantled the dev team and pretty much said no more patches, no more content, this game is done. And but honestly, this game does a hell of a lot right in a shooter that I would really like to see in more shooters on the newer generation. Now I'm not going to bash a game that is already long dead, so in this video I'm only going to talk about what I really liked and wish was more prevalent in shooters today. First off, the weapon customization feels really authentic, as each weapon has different pre-arranged setups for each component of the weapon. That makes it look and feel really genuine, something you would find in real life. The optics and reticles were also realistically displayed, and while this could lead to some clutter when you ADS, it felt really cool to peek down an optic that was so realistically rendered. The game also had a really good fluid cover system where you could stand or crash behind cover and then press a key that allowed you to lean left or right and up and down so you can peek around and above and under cover, so you can just really, you know, get that angle on your target without really, you know, really revealing too much of your body. And it was a really good system that was really cool and honestly probably one of the best things to come from the game. Body system was also pretty cool, if slightly overpowered, and it was a great way to encourage team play and pretty much ensure that your team is made up of 5 teams of 2 guys winning together rather than 10 one-man armies. Now, in this footage you're going to see me running alone a lot, just because to get footage for this I actually had to go to a lot of foreign servers and stuff overseas where they didn't really speak English, so I couldn't really run too much team play. But you know, the buddy system back when I played on, when it first came out, it actually worked really well and it kept people together because you rely so much on that teammate for ammo and health that you really want to stay within at least, you know, 20 feet of each other. Now, as I played this game, I also started to think of how this, you know, genre of shooter has pretty much been abandoned in the AAA shooter market. The tactical team and objective-based shooter is pretty much dead, with Medal of Honor being iced. And that is really sad, because I definitely miss games like this. Games that put you behind the rifle of your soldier, and you know, you very rarely, if ever, left that. And, now, I'm not saying that, you know, games like, you know, Insurgency don't do that. I mean, that's a hardcore tactical shooter. I'm talking just about your standard tactical objective-based shooter, not hardcore, like Battlefield only infantry, like what Medal of Honor pretty much was. And I'm not saying Battlefield isn't good, but in my mind, the infantry style suffers from the amount of vehicles that are in the way that they're implemented. You know, in real life, you wouldn't have an average soldier pilot a jet in the battle, get shot down, steal a tank, and then while he's on that, pick up a 50 cal sniper off the ground and go on a kill streak. It just takes away from the immersion a little bit in my mind, being that versatile. Like, real soldiers can't do everything in the battlefield, they have to rely on others to do that stuff and to support them as they move throughout their mission. It just takes a little bit of the immersion away in my mind. But, you know, compared to that Medal of Honor, where it was always focused on that smart tactical infantry gameplay, which is what I thrive for in video games. Sure, it had a massive problem with explosive spam, but you were always just a man and his weapon. Vehicles were more a means to an end. You could call in a helicopter to shoot a target, or to fast rope out of it for a third spawn option, which is way more badass than parachuting out of one. And you could order mortar strikes or UAV scans, but never did you leave your, you know, your soldier. And you know, that combined with the beautiful and believable aesthetic of the weapons really just led to a very authentic feel that I got while playing that I really haven't had in a game in quite some time. I really want to see the shooter of Subdomina brought back into the spotlight of the gaming world, and either a new Medal of Honor game come out or have a spiritual successor to it. Anyways, guys, that's all for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you all on the next one. Bye-bye.